This is BJ from Bakersfield, California at Chalk Talk. Today we're going to share with you how to wax, just your basic clear wax. We've had a lot of requests for this, and we've actually learned a new, easier way to wax this year ourselves, so that's what we're going to share with you today. All right, so here is what we're going to wax today. This is a painted cabinet door, freshly painted with Provence chalk paint. And normally what we do for cabinet doors is we knock down the chalk paint a little bit. So the first thing I'm going to do is smooth it with a little 320 sandpaper. This is an optional step. You don't have to do this, but it sure makes your cabinets or your furniture smoother and have a much higher sheen from the wax that you end up applying. So you can do it by hand, lightly smoothing the area that you want to wax. It does pick up quite a bit of dust when you do it, but easily cleaned up. So it will lighten your color just a little as well. And I don't know if you can see that in the camera, but don't worry, the color does return when you put the wax on. Now, when you have a larger area to wax, I recommend that you use a sanding sponge if you're gonna smooth prior to waxing. Because if your smoothing is not uniform, you could have highs and lows in your sheen. So if you're using your hand, like I did a minute ago, you may not have equal pressure everywhere. So I'm gonna wrap my favorite sandpaper, which is this reusable, washable sandpaper, around my sanding sponge. And now, when I sand the interior of the door, or any large flat surface like a table or the top of a dresser, I'm gonna have uniform pressure and uniform sanding. Just get a good grip on it. Doesn't take any time at all to get the entire piece smooth and ready for waxing. I'm just gonna get in my corners good. The sanding sponges that are angled work much better, and they will get right up to the edge here. So next, you do want to get rid of your dust. I usually will use a dry brush and just get the dust off. You can blow it off as well. And you're ready to start. So here at Chalk Talk, we sell two different kinds of brushes. This one is what we sold for years, and you may have seen this in other shops as well. It does have a very flat top to it, but they both are natural bristle brushes. They do load differently, however. So if you have a brush like this, you will load it by tapping a little bit of wax onto the end of the brush. And because I use this brush and I load it differently, I'm going to grab it and show you how much wax I'm talking about when I say a little bit. And this is the most important part, and the part where most people kind of go wrong from this point forward. They put too much wax on their brush, and therefore they put too much wax on their piece, and it gets worse from there. So when I have this wax brush, which is an Annie Sloan wax brush, it has a point to it. And the way I load this brush is turn it upside down, and I just twist my wrist twice, and that's why my can looks like this, because it grabs all the wax from the side of the can. So I'm going to do that, and I don't know if you can see, but it kind of self-loads the right amount of wax that I need. And I don't have to worry about overloading. I don't have to remind myself that you don't scoop the wax out with this brush. It is a light tapping to get a very small amount. And now I'm ready to spread my wax. So I'm gonna go on this area that we first did by hand, and you can see the color has come back very nicely. And you wanna do small areas at a time. The wax dries very quickly. And if you don't remove the excess immediately, it's going to be very difficult to do. So I'm going to put this down, and I'm going to grab my shop towel, and I fold it in quarters because it works best with the way we remove the wax. The first thing I'm going to do is massage this area in kind of like hand cream, as if you were rubbing your hands together and spreading that hand cream around. A little bit of pressure is applied as I'm doing this, and it's usually 5 to 10 seconds. And if I turn my shop towel over, you can see quite a bit of wax has been removed, and this is the most that you get off. So what I'm going to do is turn it to a clean area, because I don't want to spread the wax. I want to continue to remove more. So I'm going to place it down, and now it doesn't grab my cloth anymore, and it allows me to slide it back and forth. And during this sliding, there is no pressure from my hand. I am not pushing hard or pushing down. It's just the friction of the sliding that is removing more wax. And again, this is just another 5 to 10 seconds. So I turn it over and I can see there's a little bit of wax that has come off again. Might be hard to see on camera, but usually 3 little squares is what I end up using before I'm done. So I'm going to get a clean square again, and we're going to slide one more time. Again, with no pressure, no pushing. I'm not breaking a sweat and I'm not working hard. Just 5 to 10 seconds of smoothing again. And I virtually see nothing remaining on my cloth, which is what we want to see at this moment. Now, there is one great test that you can do to make sure you have taken the proper amount off, and that's your diagonal finger swipe test. You can use a little pressure here, because you want to make sure when you swipe your finger and you turn it and look in the light that you do not see your finger mark. And that lets you know you have taken off enough wax and it's not going to feel sticky, tacky, and you won't leave finger marks when you touch it. All that there is left to do now is for the wax to be exposed to the atmosphere and cure or turn hard as a rock. And it will do that in 5 to 21 days. So during that time, you want to treat it like fine china. Don't drag things across the surface of this. And certainly don't set things down hard if this was a dresser top. You could set things on it lightly, but I would rotate them so that it would have a chance to cure equally everywhere. And in my neck of the woods, it's closer to 5 days. It all is relative depending on the humidity in your climate. So the poor folks in the south, they're waiting more like 21 days. But us girls here in Bakersfield, where it's really hot but very dry, are getting a quicker cure time. So I'm going to wax just a little bit more of the flatter area. Again, 2 swirls. I have just the proper amount on. And this area is not too large to wax. It's probably the largest I would wax. Almost the size of an 8x10 sheet of paper. Clean chop towel. And remember, the first step is massaging like hand cream. So I'm going to do that. And get the majority of the wax off, and you can feel a change in the cloth starting to slide and not grabbing. Again, I have a cloth full of wax. Turn over to a clean spot, and I'm just going to start sliding. No pressure here from my hand, just the friction again of the cloth, and it's still picking up additional wax. 5 to 10 seconds of this. I'm going to get me a clean part of my towel. And another 5 to 10 seconds of sliding. Sorry. So it's 1 massage, 2 slides. If that's how you can remember it, it works for me. And I can do this while I'm watching TV, because you don't even have to look at it. So I'm done here. I'm going to do my little finger swipe test. Look at it in the light. I don't see it. I'm good to go. If I see any blotchy areas, I can always go back and add wax to those areas. And usually that's probably what the issue is, so I would try that first. Other than that, there is nothing else to this, so don't make it harder than this. One massage, two swipes, fingerprint test, and you're done. You move on to the next section. That's it from us here at Chalk Chalk. If you have any questions, you can always call. But wishing you the best in your projects.